Hey guys, Dagan here from PMTV UK, and this is a cool video. In this video, I'll be showing you the best amp modelers on the market right now. What a time to be alive. I hope we realize how lucky we are. I certainly do, I hope you do as well. So many amplifiers, so many effects, so much everything in one little convenient box from companies like Headrush and Line 6. It's fantastic. What a time to be alive. Whether you want a vintage style Fender amplifier or a Dumble, which costs more than a house, or a modern modded Marshall or a Mesa Boogie dual rectifier, you haven't got to spend hundreds of thousands of tens of thousands of many of your monies, just a little bit, and get it all in one little convenient box. Every single venue under the planet, and this is a fact, has stairs. Stairs suck when you try and carry a Marshall stack up them to play your gig in front of either 10 or 20 people, so it's so inconvenient having these fantastic modelers on the market these days, and technology's advanced so much since they first came about in the 80s, late 80s, early 90s, with the first kind of amp modeling. It's in blind tests, which you'll see online, you cannot tell the difference. It's a feel thing as well. All modern day modelers feel like they're like the valve amps they're supposed to. Under your fingers, different amps do feel different. And if you don't believe me, rock up to a PMT store and try a few out, and they do feel different under your fingers. They've managed to nail it. 2020 is a great year, but besides the whole COVID thing, let's just gloss over that. But yes, I'm here today to talk about amp modelers. Now, a lot of these guys have effects built in, and if you want to watch a video solely on multi-effects and what the best multi-effects are, there's also a video on our channel, PMTV UK, where I chat about the best multi-effects available. But you can kind of get the vibe of that in this video as well. We'll be chatting about offerings from Strymon, Boss, Headrush, and of course Line 6, all the usual suspects, and Kemper, a little bit of Kemper thrown in there as well, and with some honorable mentions at the end, because there's so many different variants out there, I can't cram them all into one video. So if you want to add anything or tell me and the rest of the guys how much you love a certain modeler, please comment down below, because it's a lot of fun to read. So that's enough talking, let's get into some specs and some sounds. I'll be playing my lovely Gibson SG Angus Young through Tuatec cables into the modeler of my choosing, into an Alto TS210, which is hitting my face with sound, XLR'd out into a little Zoom H6. So let's get started, starting with the iconic Line 6 Helix, and this is my own personal old Helix, a cracking unit that's been gigs hard and never let me down. It sounds fantastic. One of my favorites, always a go-to, is the keay rectifier setting. Line 6 have always done a great job replicating dual rectifiers. Big wall of saturation, that American saturation. But it does so much more than that. At the tap of your foot, you can go from modern Mesa Boogie to 90s Britpop to 70s disco and everything in between, seamlessly, with the most amazing tones you've ever heard. There's 45 amplifiers in this Line 6 Helix, 30 cabs, 16 microphones, and over 70 effects. It's absolutely crackers. What they've done is, instead of just the old school Line 6, where, I mean, Line 6 have always been pioneers in modeling, the pod is iconic, which we'll talk about later in this video, they're treading the fine line between digital tweakability and analog simplicity and warmth. They've essentially digitally dismantled, try and say that three times fast, loads of amplifiers and picked each part out and modeled it, as opposed to modeling one final sound. They've modeled the amplifiers in their entirety. So when you change things like the sag and the low end and the presence, their amp reacts like that original amplifier, not just generically coding through all the amps in the Helix. Each one is very, very different. And that's the same with the cabs and the microphones. The microphones are ranging from industry standard ones that we're all used to seeing in studios around the globe, all the way to super fancy models of £1,000 microphones, which are rarest of the rare, and they've done a cracking job of modeling them. It's one of the most powerful guitar units ever created as well. It's not just for guitar, you can use bass with it, you can sing through it, there's an XLR on the top. Speaking of inputs and outputs, there's 10 inputs and 12 outputs, four of which being external effects loops, if you want to add any other pedals into this fantastic thing and pop them in the chain. Speaking of the chain and the overall power of this thing, it features dual core DSP technology, which is a fancy way of saying you can do loads at once. You can have up to 4 amps running at once and 32 effects all on at once, coming out with 6 outputs to different whatever. You do so much with this. Like, every time I chat to someone at Line 6, they always talk about how much it can do. I never use the tenth of what this could do, but it's nice to know it's there just in case I want to run 32 effects into 4 amps into 6 different outputs, just in case. And one of the main reasons I love the Helix so much is because it's so easy to use. It's remarkably easy to use. So the banks, the scroll through the lovely presets. When you click on a preset that you want, either the amazing ones from Line 6 or the ones you've created yourself, tap it and you go into stomp box mode, where you can turn on the stomp boxes as if it was a pedal board in front of you, and you can see your signal chain on the screen there. Now these 12 buttons, this is one of the coolest things about the Helix, are all touch sensitive. So if you want to alter, say, the tape delay, just tap the button on the side, or you can scroll to it with the little scroll guy here. Tap it on the side and you can alter all the parameters that you want. And if you mess it up, you tap the button and it goes back to the original parameter from the effect itself. You can't really go wrong with this. And if you get lost in a menu, click the home button and you go back to the home screen. It's absolutely kick-ass. So before we hear it some more as well, there's 3 expression pedal outputs on the top, as well as this lovely expression pedal on the right. Super heavy duty. It's totally MIDI capable, so you can either switch things on and off with it with the MIDI, or get it controlled by a MIDI clock or something. There's a Variac output, so you can control the tunings and guitars within your Variac Line 6 guitar inside the Helix. You can turn lighting rigs on and off with it. It'll make you dinner if you treat it nice. It's a remarkable thing. So let's hear it some more. Actually, before that, there's snapshots. Quick little thing about snapshots. Snapshots are presets within presets, okay? So when you tap both of these down, you go into snapshot mode, which is both the banks down. And the snapshots essentially mean you can turn things on and off within a preset. So instead of you going back to that main bank mode and picking another preset, within that one, I keep saying preset, one preset, you can change different parameters within the snapshots, okay? So you have a clean rhythm, bit gainy amp, go for a lead. You can actually turn the gain up on the amp within a snapshot. You haven't got to add another amp or put something else in. You can turn a drive on. You can do so much with a snapshot. But this is a quick little video. I could be here all day harping on about the Helix, but here are some more of my favorite sounds. It reacts like a proper valve amp as well. This is based off an A30. You all know what that might be. Put some delay on and a mid boost because we can. Oh, that's a slapback delay. This is always one of my favorite ones, the Brit J45 normal. So this is the J45 on the normal channel because there's 2 circuits on the J45. Change that to a tube screener because we can. And let's add a delay in. Just go to the end of the signal chain, give that knob a click, down a delay. Let's go for some simple delay. Such a fantastic thing. Let's hear some cleans now. Tweed blues. This might be distorted. His tweeds sound great when they're cranked up. And that's what Line 6 has done. But I want to hear some cleans. It's the touch sensitivity, which you only kind of get with an old F-style valve amp. Mm-hmm. why not let's add a Minotaur in. We all know that classic iconic pedal. And a compressor, because it sounds mint. So those were some specs, sounds and sights on the iconic, fantastic, beautiful Line 6 Helix, one of my all-time favourite pedals ever to be invented. I love it for three reasons. It sounds fantastic, it's super easy to use, and it's very versatile as well. I've not even scratched the surface of what this can do, so you've got to rock up to a PMT store and try one out for yourself. There are some other fabulous Helix products as well. Besides the full fat version, there's the Helix LT, which is the little brother, but still features the same dual core DSP technology, so still has the same internal engine. There's just a few less ins and outs up top. There's no XLR input. There's less loops for the effect. There's no scribble strips on the front, so you can't really see what you're doing, but there is an option on that lovely 6.2 inch LED display to show you what the buttons themselves do. Still has the same touch capacitive switches on the front and an expression pedal. It's just slightly not as robust, I'd say, as this guy, but it's 99.9% of the way there. It still has over 200 amps, cabs, effects, and microphones in it. It's a phenomenal piece of kit. Oh, there's a smaller one as well, the HX Stomp, which is the same tones but on a much smaller scale. It's only about this big. There's three foot switches. It's a smaller signal chain, but the amps and effects are the same. You can just put less in the line, which is probably something I would use over the 32 effects and 4 amps at once, but the Stomp's great. The whole Helix range is great. You've got to check them out. This is the Boss GT1000 and it's Boss's flagship product, their flagship amp modeler. This thing is phenomenal. Boss have been making amp modelers for years now, but never quite like this. It's the vibe is still there from the old products like the GT100, but tonally it's next level. It's fantastic. There's 50 banks of 5 presets, so that is a lot of presets you can store. Also, sorry, I forgot to mention, the main thing about this guy is Boss have brought Bluetooth technology to the amp modeler game, so you can Bluetooth any device you've got, whether it be an iPhone or an Android phone or an iPad, and change the parameters wirelessly through your fantastic Boss GT1000. With that as well, it's really cool because one of the first things lovely Mark Harley from Boss told me about the GT1000 is this is great because you say you're playing a gig and you want to make sure your guitar sounds good out front if you've got a wireless, or even if you haven't got a wireless, it's got a built-in looper, okay? Loop a guitar track into the GT1000 and just have it playing. Put your guitar down, go and stand at the back of the venue with your Bluetooth device and alter your tone while you're playing on stage because of that loop. It's such a cool feature. This thing is super easy to use. A little thing as well that I really enjoy is the first thing on the right is the guitar input. The amount of modelers and effect pedals where the guitar input's like in the middle somewhere and you've got to lean over and try and find it, put it right on the end. Great, I hope someone at Boss got a raise for that. Just next to the output. So there's a guitar input, guitar output, there are they're stereo. Forgot what I was saying for a second there. Quarter inch outputs, either XLR or jack. There's a couple of loops in the back as well if you want to put external pedals in or rock this as a 4 cable method. There's also some external expression pedals and extra switches if you want to control anything externally that isn't on the front. But the front is super easy to use. So I was saying there's 50 banks. Have a gander. These are the 50 banks. And there's 5 presets within each bank. Go along the bottom here. And you'll notice these 3 little buttons may light up. These turn on and off effects stomp boxes within each preset, okay? So say if you're in preset 2 and you want to every now and then turn a delay on or a overdrive. Have the delay as 1, the overdrive as 2, and something else as 3. It's a cracking thing to do, but you can also configure this to any configuration internally if you like. You could only have maybe 1 and 2 working as preset buttons and the rest to turn stomp boxes on and off. You can totally change the way this thing works internally. But I'm not going to get into that, that's too much for right now. Page switch here shows you the effect you're on, either in big, bold, this is the bank, this is the effect, this is the preset, or what the preset's called, or what's turning them on. So this is turning a DS1 solo, which will turn on a DS1 and a lead boost. There's a regular DS1 and a tuner on the right. Expression pedal, as you'd expect, works as a volume pedal if it's set as such, but when you tap it down, there is a click function to turn it into a wah or a whammy, or to change the rate of a modulation or delay. It's cool what you can do with this. You can configure it to any way that you want, either via the fantastic Boss app or that Bluetooth app I was talking about before. It's totally MIDI capable. There's a USB out, so you can use this as an interface and record directly into your DAW. It's a fantastic thing. Let's get into some sounds now. And what I will keep saying in modeling amp videos are the fact that one isn't necessarily better than the other. The Helix, the Headrush, the Fractals, the Kempers, they're all fantastic, but all feel slightly different and have their own unique spin on classic amplifiers. They're all slightly different, and that's why you've got to come into a PMT store and try one for yourself. I did mention feel different, and the cool thing about this is it has the AID technology in, which is the augmented impulse response dynamic feature, which means it's got the tube logic. Boss are fantastic. Check out my video for 8 facts you didn't know about Boss pedals, by the way, on our channel. It's really, really cool. Boss are great at manipulating digital things to feel and sound like tube amps, and this has the tube logic technology in. So under your fingers, it does feel very akin to an old school tube amp, which is great and what you want. So let's hear it in the same way that you would in a PMT store. Bank 1, Preset 1, Premium Drive. Go along the pages to see what this will turn on. So control one is changing the channel on the amplifier, which is, I can't tell what it is because I haven't got that screen up, of whatever amplifier is modeled in the premium drive. Fantastic. Let's have a fiddle through a few more presets. Let's go through the banks. There's acoustic simulators. I always forget this about Boss products. Boss have some of the best acoustic simulators on the planet. I bet you've never heard an Angus Young SG sound like that before. All the tunes in your band which involve an acoustic guitar, Boss has you covered with a GT1000. I was on the hunt to find a clean sound to show you guys, but I stumbled across this and it's mint. So this thing not only has very fun pads in and acoustic simulators, it's also got all of Boss's new DD500 range, all the distortions, the EQs, the reverbs and modulations and delays, everything from those flagship individual pedals are all crammed into this one unit. It's got a lovely bite under your fingers, which you only get from valve amps. So that was the Boss GT1000, an amazing little unit with technology we've never seen before in the world of pedals. It's cracking, you need to try one and hear one. With headphones on, this sounds fantastic as well. Boss are great at making things sound great through XLR cables, great through headphones, great through your computer. It's just great. This is the Strymon Iridium. And this is one of my favorite pedals to come out with Strymon, all favorite pedals ever. It's essentially many beautiful amplifiers and impulse responses in housed in a lovely Strymon enclosure. And it's very easy to use and it sounds fantastic. Pretty much one input up top, stereo outputs, a left and a right with a little switch to choose between mono and stereo. It's MIDI capable, so you can turn this guy on and off on a MIDI clock or control it via however MIDI way you desire. Expression pedal as well to change the parameters of the drive. That's alter the parameter of the drive, I should say. I'm all giddy about this pedal because it's super easy to use. On the front, level control, how loud you want the pedal to be. Three-band EQ does what it says on the tin, bass, middle, and treble. Got the drive up top left. We'll get to that shortly. Bottom right is a room control. So this is essentially an amp and cab in a box. This is an amplifier right here, and it weighs nothing and is powered off a 9-volt power supply. The room gives you the feeling of the amp being in the room with you. Like, it's like a delay almost. Like, have a gander or listen all the way down, all the way up. And you can blend that in till it's a natural sound. So, foot switch wise, bypass control on the right. This is the dry sound, for example, just to prove there's no amps off screen. As clean as it comes. That's a Marshall Super Lead right there. And the favorite switch is essentially a preset switch. I will have this set up as a clean sound, essentially. So the main sound is a dirty sound. Roll the volume back on your guitar, because this thing reacts like a valve amp to get a clean sound, or use the favorite switch as a clean sound. Speaking of those lovely amps, there's two switches, two little toggle switches with three notches on each of them. The one on the left chooses between your amp types. There is round, chime, and crunch. Round is an old 68 Fender Deluxe. Chime is an old AC30, and punch is a Marshall Super Lead. It's phenomenal. And within each of those three, there are three different cab types, three impulse responses given to you by Strymon themselves. And they're very fancy impulse responses like Own Hammer and other crackers brands like that. So there's on the punch one, on the Marshall one, there is a old school 4x12, a 2x12, and an Alnico 4x12. 2x12. Old school Alnico. They've all got their own unique characteristics. It's absolutely amazing. And they differ between each amp, so it's not as if you have the same three cabs for all three amplifiers. So the round one is the Fender Deluxe. Three different cab types. And that's pretty much it in a nutshell. It's a cab and amp modeller in the size of a tiny Strymon pedal with a preset built in, three different amp sounds, nine different impulse responses. It's stereo if you want it to be. Let's hear some more sounds, shall we? Cab A is always the cab you'd expect to find with said Fender model, Vox model, and Marshall model. Who's out of Vox now? It's got a lovely bright squeakiness that Voxes have. Bravo, Strymon, this is fantastic. Let's see if it breaks up like a Vox. Breaks up and then some. of the Marshall now. This is one of my favorite sounds of all time. It's even got that percussiveness to it, which old Marshalls have. This thing is just dying to have some overdrives put in front of it to take it to new sonic plateaus. Let's end on some cleans on the Marshall. With the 2x12. This thing's fantastic. This is the Headrush pedalboard. And it's an astounding piece of kit because Headrush realized what all guitarists like, and that is really cool gimmicks. We like things that light up, and we like things that are touchscreen. It's got a touchscreen, it's got a 3-inch touchscreen. That's one of the main cool things about the Headrush, besides the fact it sounds absolutely fantastic. With its 33 different amp models, 15 cab models, 10 mics, and oodles of effects, there's not much you can't do with the Headrush pedal board. This is the big lad. There's also the Headrush gig board, which is a slightly smaller one, and there's the Headrush looper board, which is solely designed for looping. This thing is unbelievable. One input up top, stereo outputs, whether 1/4-inch jack or XLR. There's a stereo effects loop, there's USB out. The thing can be controlled totally by MIDI as well. It's a phenomenal thing, and what is cool is the fact that because there's a touchscreen, there's not a lot going on up top. There's 6-foot switches down below, which can be assigned to anything you like. I've got it in stomp box mode at the minute, so it's turning on and off all the stomp boxes within this preset, which is the Tracy Guns preset. The fabulous Tracy Guns, who I have the pleasure of calling a good friend of mine, has his own preset pack for the Headrush, and it comes from the factory with Tracy Guns' preset. So you get all the lovely ones from Headrush, as well as Tracy's badass 80s ones, from lovely 80s cleans to Van Halen style phasing, all the way through to all of LA Guns' back catalog. Unfortunately, I've got Tracy's fabulous fingers. To the screen, let's get back to the screen and the overall front panel. You'll notice there's not a lot of buttons and dials and switches because it's all internally in that screen. I mean, what's the best way to say this? We're all familiar with smartphones and iPads and stuff, and we know where to go in said smartphones and iPads to find certain settings. And Headrush have latched onto that and thought, let's put this technology and user interface into a guitar product, and it works flawlessly. So instead of having lots of menus and switches on the front, there's only the important ones. To the right-hand side, you've got the master volume, a little control knob here if for some reason you don't want to use the touchscreen, headphone volume and auxiliary volume input. There's an auxiliary input up top. So the screen, these three knobs, control, if you don't, again, you want to use the touchscreen. Say I'm on the green overdrive here. It controls, and it's very, very quick. It's super quick. So I'll do these effects corresponding along with the controls. But away from the controls, as you'll notice as well, you can do a lot in one preset on the Headrush. Tracy's got this set up, so there's two heads running at once. I love a good two-head setup because you can have one running hotter and treblier, and one running less hot and a bit more bassy. And that is tonally very different to one amp running in the middle. It's really cool, especially when there's two different cabs, which there is. So all you need to do is double tap something to alter it. Change the cabs, change the speakers, all at the touch of a finger. You can even color code it, because all these little strips down here, you can color code to certain effects or to certain presets, whatever your heart desires. So that is basically, look how long the signal chain is as well. You do so much in such a little space. It's fantastic. Let's hear some more tones now. All rigs. Let's go all rigs. Have a little scooch through. Need somebody. That sounds like I need somebody to listen to this awesome tone I've got. Feels good under your fingers as well. It feels like a valve amp. Let's keep going, watching tides. That is a Fender Deluxe Reverb model. One thing you might notice as well is Headrush have the option to change the axis of the microphone on a foot switch itself. Not on this one, this has a bright switch for the Deluxe Reverb that we're on right now. But changing the axis massively alters your sound, and it's cool to see Headrush put that on the front panel of their amps. So it's a cool little function to have. So that's the Headrush. It does a lot and it looks really cool whilst doing it. Super versatile, incredibly easy to use, and you can touch it. This is the Line 6 Pod Pro HD. The name Pod is iconic with guitar players. The Line 6 Pod was one of the first ever mass-produced, widely well-received amp modelers on the market, and they kept that name until recently when they brought out the Helix and the fancy other modelers, but the Pod is still going very strong. In its latest incarnation, the Pod Pro HD, this is the rack mount version right here. Some of the tones in it are absolutely amazing. You can get pretty much any sound from a pod. Everybody knows this. Whether you play guitar, bass, want to use it with keys or vocals, you totally can. It's a great thing to use, and it's very easy to use as well. Input on the front and on the back in case you want to keep it in a rack mount with wireless systems and all that. Stereo out, there's a stereo effects loop that's totally MIDI capable as well, so you can control it via MIDI. But the great thing about the pod is its ease of use, and the presets sound great from the factory. On the front panel, you've got a 3-band EQ down here on the right, next to a presence control to take off some of the high end when you really crank it loud, just underneath a master control, master volume, next to the channel volume, and a drive control on the left of that. There's an XLR input on the left as well, just above the guitar input, which I'm using right now. In case you do want to sing into your pod, I mean, seriously, this is a great studio tool. And because of the Helix, these things are way cheaper than they were when they were new, so you get that incredible performance and tone for less money than you would have done originally. There's a number of different screens you can choose when using the Pod HD by Line 6. This is my favorite though, where you can actually see the signal chain. You can see all the little effects and amp blocks in that chain. Scrolling along, you will notice that these parameters change at the bottom, and there is numbers next to each parameter, which corresponds to one of these four controls down below. So you can change the rate of delays, the decay of reverbs, the rate of modulations, or how much drive you want in a Tube Screamer clone, all with these four knobs here. But I just love the presets from the factory. They're awesome. So let me show you a few of my favorites. I'm not gonna show you them all though, just some of my favorites. I'm gonna leave the deep diving for you to do in your local PMT store. Rock up and plug one of these in and have hours of fun just sitting fiddling through the presets. There's 512 presets in this guy, 22 amp models, 8 microphone choices, over 100 effects, and 16 cabinets, I think. That's one hell of an afternoon playing with that right there. We'll be right back. You get the gist. It does a lot of this fantastic thing. So there's some famous sounds in here as well. You will see a couple of jimmies thrown around and a couple of echoes and a couple of Hell's Bells. Line 6 always aptly name their presets. This one is obviously very Irish and very, very delayed. What I love about Line 6 putting famous guitar tones in their products is the fact that it will make you play a certain way when you hear it, obviously the track it's based off, but you can also use that sound to create your own riffs and think of something no one's ever heard of with that sound. Shh, I won't tell anyone. This thing does a lot, from auto wahs to swells to classic Fender amps to modern Bogner Uber shells and everything in between. If you don't want to edit it on the front panel as well, even though it's really easy to do, you can use Line 6's editing software, which is free to download from their website. You see, you can't teach an old dog new tricks. This thing, it sounds just as good as the new dogs. This is a Kemper Profiler, and it's an unbelievable piece of kit. This is one of the best things you guitarists out there will ever play through. Kempers are fantastic things. It's a profiler though, not a modeler. I'll explain what that means shortly. This is the head version. They come in two different variants, the head or toaster version or rack mount, as well as a powered version of the rack mount or head. This is the unpowered regular head version, and it looks awesome in white. This is a, what's the best way to describe it? Probably just as a profiler. You get amp modelers, which have lots of effects built in and cool things like that, which model amplifiers. They, like the Helix, models the power amp, the preamp, and all the goodies in between. Put it all together and you get the model of an amplifier that you're trying to copy. This profiles it. This listens to the sound and then copies it digitally. Wizardry happens inside of it. You might have seen online how they profile amps. They set up lots of microphones on an amp and set this to profile mode. This then listens to that sound and then copies it. As opposed to replicating the path digitally to make the sound happen at the end, it takes the sound and copies it, essentially. But when it comes to tweaking it, if I want to change the bass, middle, treble, I will be altering a copied sound. Think of it as if you've got a picture and you're using an app on your phone to kind of manipulate it. You're kind of bending it in places so it fits your style, which is totally cool, as opposed to changing what it initially was in the first place, which is digitally what you're doing with a modeler, whereas profiling, you're manipulating something that's already been and happened. That's one of the main differences. It doesn't necessarily mean it's better or worse. That's just the difference between profiling and modeling. Now that's out the way, this thing's fantastic. Like I said, I'm using the Silver Jubilee setting right now. I will show you some more settings in a bit. There's a few different modes: browser mode, performance mode, profiler mode. I'm not going to get into the nitty gritty and show you how to change the frequency of the low cut and all that kind of malarkey. I'm just going to show you what it sounds like and show you how awesome it is. On the right hand side of the profiler, up top, you will see the output volume, alongside the first effects block. Well, the first one I'm going to talk about today is actually the last effects block, because these are the effects that usually go after the preamp. So delays, reverbs, and some modulations. The effect you want to put in front of the preamp are over here on the left-hand side, the stomps, which are compressors and effects that, like distortions, overdrives, and octavers, and things that actually manipulate the signal itself, as opposed to manipulating it in a way to make it delay or modulate. In the middle is where you'll find the buttons to manipulate the bulk of your tone. So the amplifier, the EQ, and the cabinet. What I love about Kemper is they put everything on the front panel, which is important to us guitar players. If you want to alter the modulation, two buttons right here. There's no internal menus, delay and reverb, and a noise gate on the left, because some of these Kempers are used by a lot of metal artists, and a noise gate is crucial. So having everything that you need directly on the front panel is super easy. And earlier when I was on about manipulating the EQ, very easy as well. It's like an amplifier. Down the bottom here, you will see the controls that light up beautifully and alter any parameter that it says on here, whether it be changing an effect or the EQ of an amplifier, which you can read by these little arrows right here. Input and output wise, guitar goes in on the right, there's a headphone output on the left. On the back, there's monitor outs, there's direct outs, there's stereo XLR outs. The whole thing can be run via MIDI. You can get the profiler foot switch to control it all in a live situation. This thing is phenomenal. That's kind of all what it does. I'm not gonna go too deep into changing things. I just wanna show you guys how awesome this sounds. Here are a few of my favorite Kemper presets. It reacts so much like an amp, it's kind of scary. I know the Silver Jubilee so well by Marshall, it's one of my favorite amps, and this is just crazy. The Kemper is extremely responsive to the input that's hitting it, whether it be the picking dynamic, hard or soft. Or the overall volume of your guitar. It might not have as many effects as other modelers built inside of it. It hasn't got lots of different mic placements you can change on a whim, but the profiles you get in the Kemper feel a certain way. They feel more akin to a valve amp. I love the Helix. I'm a Fractal user myself personally, and I think that this has the best amp models in a feel thing. Obviously in a band scenario, in the mix, you won't be able to tell the difference between the GT1000 or the Helix or anything like that. The Helix is a force to be reckoned with, but this just feels more akin to an amp. Granted, I've only been on my lovely Silver Jubilee profile. Let's play with a few more profiles. There's hundreds. It comes with hundreds. Obviously, you can download loads of free ones online or pick some of your favorite ones from all the celebrity guitarists out there, but it comes with so many from every amp under the sun, whether it be vintage Dumbles or modern Marshalls. What's cool about profilers as well is it actually says what it is, as opposed to beating around the bush like other products like Boss and Line 6. It's like, this is an AC30 clean with an SM57 in front of it. We'll be right back. So when it comes to adding effects like reverb, delay, and modulation, that's really easy to do in the profiler. But I'm going to say if it is, if you want to add an overdrive to something, it will work, but I would recommend getting an already profiled version of, say if you want a JSM-800, great JSM-800 profiles in it, and you can add a tube screamer in the Kemper. If you want a better tube screamer JSM-800, download a profile that's already had one recorded in it for Kemper, if that makes sense. So with that being a bad thing, I will still say that this is one of the best sounding modelers on the planet. So there we have it, ladies and gents, some sights, sounds and specs on some of what I believe to be the best modelers on the face of the planet right now. Obviously, all have lots of effects in, besides that Iridium, which is a fantastic little beast. All have lots of amps in them. They're fantastic things. Honorable mentions as well. The new Moore stuff is fantastic, the Zoom stuff, and you can't go wrong with Fractal, even though it's to use. These are so much easier than Fractal stuff, even though Fractal stuff is awesome. You get the gist. I haven't went super in-depth in all these. I'll leave that for you to, when you come into a PMT store, plug them in and have a good little half an hour in a studio room with headphones on or through some monitors or through a PA cab, rocking out on these modelers to find the perfect one for you. There's literally a sound for everyone, any genre, any guitar ability, any style. Modelers are fantastic things these days. And like I said at the start, I've been using one for years and it's not only helped my back, but also helped me expand my kind of guitar sound knowledge using sounds that I never would use for certain things. It's a lot of fun to fiddle with. Us guitar players love tweaking with things. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTV UK on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music related content. If you want any more information on any of the modelers I've chatted about here today, get your fine self to pmtonline.co.uk or call into one of our forever expanding lovely PMT stores. We are PMT House of Rock on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of these with nice filters on. I've been Dagan and I shall see you next time.